Fictional gadgets and tech that actually exists. Exploding pens and metal jaws can't exist in real life, can they? Or picture Batman. That guy once used a weapons-grade canister of something called Shark Repellent Bat-Spray to repel a freaking great white shark. Surely such devices don't exist in real life, do they? Wrong. Never underestimate humanity's inventiveness when it comes to coming up with bizarre, cutting-edge technology to create. In fact, if you can imagine it, someone has probably tried to build or create it somewhere. Today, the difference between science fiction and reality is almost unnoticeably thin, thanks to the development of some truly amazing devices and gadgets, using our newly discovered wealth of resources and knowledge. In today's video, we bring you a list of 5 mind-blowing sci-fi-like technology marvels. Needless to say, get ready to be thoroughly amazed. AirTouch displays are first on our list. We're all very used to touchscreens, but this could completely change how we work and communicate. Thanks to the AirTouch panel, people would be able to use the touchscreen without actually touching it. AirTouch displays have been used in some of the most popular sci-fi TV shows and motion pictures, and now many businesses are already working on producing this technology on a commercial scale. These companies are combining technology from virtual reality headsets to create a display that users can view, although they're not yet as good as the ones in the movies. Another amazing gadget on our list is the underwater car. It seems like the only places where cars can travel on land and in water are in movies. But what if we told you that Rinspeed developed a concept car that's completely submersible? It's a car. It's a submarine. It's the Rinspeed Scuba. Swiss-based car maker Rinspeed is renowned for its restoration of vintage vehicles and customization of well-liked sports cars from Porsche and Subaru. However, none of these choices was chosen by Rinspeed for their underwater concept automobile. Instead, they decided to model the Scuba after the Lotus Esprit. In the 1977 Roger Moore film, The Spy Who Loved Me, Bond drives his Lotus Esprit Turbo off a wharf and into the sea to get away from the bad guy. But just as you begin to believe the hero's doomed, the car's wheels retract, its fins emerge, and it transforms into a submarine that can drive through the water. The 2008 unveiling of the Scuba, an amphibious vehicle based on a Lotus Esprit that looks to fly underwater, was the result of Swiss automotive designer Frank M. Rinderknecht's decision to make the creation a reality. This modified Esprit's ability to submerge itself isn't the only fascinating feature. The vehicle, which had a modest, tuned Toyota engine before conversion, now has 3 electric motors in place of the original one, because it was converted to be totally electric. The Scuba convertible can reach 1.5 miles per hour underwater and cruises at a top speed of roughly 3 miles per hour on land. Additionally, it can dive down to a depth of 30 feet. It's priced at $2 million, which is almost the same as 5 Rolls-Royce Phantoms. Isn't that insane? Apart from underwater cars, these days we also have driverless cars. Cars that drive themselves have always been the stuff of legend. According to certain archives, the idea of autonomous vehicles has been around since the 1500s. And with the same thought in mind, inventors created remote-controlled cars in the early 20th century. Such cars have been featured in a ton of science fiction movies in the past, and such imagination was simply unrealistic as far as we were concerned at that point in time. But the race truly began 20 years ago, and ever since, numerous household names, including Google, Tesla, BMW, and Mercedes, have been vying to make it safer than the ordinary driver. In fact, some of them are more advanced than what we've seen in those science fiction movies. Speaking of science fiction, you might not have read any of the Iron Man comics, books, or other series that feature the famous hero. But you've most likely already seen Robert Downey Jr.'s Iron Man and Marvel Avengers movies. But did you ever imagine that a real-life Iron Man suit would actually exist? Well, it did, at least once. Tactical Assault Light Operator Suit, or Talos, was the official name of the project. But unlike the fictional Tony Stark, who famously made his first suit out of trash in a cave, the real-life Stark had the support of the US military. Naturally, the goal was to provide soldiers with superior tactical options and protection. Rumors circulated that these futuristic suits of armor could even provide superhuman strength, brain-responsive sensors, and liquid armor. Some defense officials said that the suit wouldn't be viable and functioning until 2026, even though the military was already in the last phases of research. But regrettably, the initiative was officially discontinued in 2019. Still, on the topic of super robots, next up on the list is the Kuratas Human Ride Robot. The Kuratas is a real, albeit expensive, gadget that was developed more as an art project or otaku plaything. It resembles a character from a Hollywood action film, is around 13 feet tall, and weighs 5 tons. This gasoline-powered robot, although looking like a tank, has a top speed of 6 miles per hour. The robot can freely move its arms, legs, and torso thanks to more than 30 hydraulic joints. Also, its 6,000 round per minute BB Gatling cannons can discharge fireworks and water bottle rockets, and the pilot can control them by smiling. Wait, so it shoots the gun when you smile? That's a serial killer's dream! Kuratas can also be controlled by a smartphone connected to a 3G network, according to a video made public a few years ago while the idea was still in its early stages. One more thing. According to the Amazon Japan website, the Kuratas cost about $1.3 million, but that price doesn't include guns. Instead, it's for a starter kit that needs to be put together. Oh, have we discussed microchip implants? In the 2006 film Casino Royale, performed by Judi Dench as M, Bond is given a microchip that records his whereabouts and measures his vital signs. This comes in handy when Daniel Craig's portrayal of the spy had a heart attack while playing poker after having his martini drugged. Although there isn't a human-sized version of this implant yet, GPS tracking has become routine thanks to cell phones and its use in a variety of apps. Today, many gadgets, like the most recent iPhone 14 series, include satellite connectivity so they can transmit emergency message when there's no phone coverage. Additionally, many modern wearable devices, including the Fitbit and Apple Watch, can access the user's biometrics, such as their heart rate and blood oxygen levels. However, medical implants are being created that, to mention a few, can help paraplegics regain their mobility, measure blood glucose for diabetics, and distribute medications. Within the next few years, brain chips that act as a brain-computer interface and boost human intelligence are also predicted to become widely used. This includes Elon Musk's Neuralink chip, which has only ever been implanted into a monkey's brain and enabled it to engage in mental games. Musk was beaten to the punch by startup Synchron, which successfully implanted a brain chip into a patient for the first time in the US, enabling him to text simply by thinking. Impressive, right? Well, moving on. How about we take a look at hibernation pods? A hibernation pod is a crucial piece of technology for any prolonged space voyage, since it enables people to sleep for ages while they silently travel through space to their destination. Almost all science fiction films that deal with interplanetary travel, such as Prometheus, Interstellar, and Passengers, include them in one way or another. However, humans probably won't make it through a multi-decade journey to space, metabolically speaking. But pods will soon be available to humans, according to the European Space Agency, or ESA. In contrast to movies, astronauts in the pods won't be shackled and will wear clothes that help reduce overheating. Additionally, sensors would be attached to their bodies to monitor their vital signs. Each pod would be placed in the middle of a row of water containers, shielding the occupants from radiation. As can be expected, given how far this technology has already come, artificial intelligence, of course, will be in charge of steering the ship while the crew snoozes. Technology like this is essential if humanity's to have any chance of ever colonizing the cosmos, especially with the race to Mars already underway and a keen eye on planets even further away. We can't end this list without mentioning invisibility cloaks, can we? Scientists might be a step closer to developing that Harry Potter-style invisibility cloak of your dreams, as a functional, real-life invisibility cloak has been developed by researchers. According to the London-based Invisibility Shield Co., an entire person can be hidden by the fully working shields. According to the company, the innovation uses a carefully designed lens array to divert a large portion of the light reflected from the topic away from the viewer. It's subsequently thrown to the left and right over the shield's front surface. Although it comes in a larger size, the producers are charging $64 for a modest shield, 310 by 210 millimeters, that can be used to hide everyday things. Would you be willing to try one? See you next time.